The poker world suffered a tragic loss this week as we learned that on Sunday, September 6th, Mike Sexton had passed away in his home from prostate cancer. I'm old enough to remember the premiere of the World Poker Tour on the Travel Channel, but I'm far too young to have known Mike Sexton, the poker pro. By the time the poker world as we know it became familiar with Sexton, it was for his legendary commentary, not for his chops on the felt. These events were fun, informative, and they had a dash of playful narration led by Mike and Vince Van Patten. They had a way of making the game feel like a script. Almost that it was off of a movie screen, larger than life, complete with high drama and eclectic characters. The WPT broadcasts were Mike's vision brought to life, and poker will forever be changed because of it. The truth is, this was just one of the many contributions Mike would make to the game. Not only did Mike have the foresight to know that the whole card camera would change the game as we know it, hence the success of the WPT, but he was also a first mover in online gaming. Mike was a major ambassador for party poker dating all the way back to its early existence, where he was the face of the Party Poker Million tournament in 2002. Mike would prove he could play as well, with most of his accolades coming late in his career, including a ninth place finish in the inaugural Big One for One drop, as well as a WPT title in Montreal 2016. But these accomplishments pale in comparison to the impact Sexton would have on the community he helped build. The poker world learned of Mike's illness just a week ago, as Linda Johnson announced that he was at home, on his deathbed, receiving 24/7 hospice care. An outpour of well wishes, support, and a flood of memories began to surface through poker Twitter. Mike Matisau hosted a truly touching tribute which brought all four corners of the community together to speak about the impact Sexton had, not only on their game, but their careers, and most importantly, their lives. I sat back and I watched. I internalized just how much this man that I barely knew had helped shape my career and my outlook for the game and community that I'm involved in. I officially met Mike once. I was playing in Ivy's room sometime late in 2014, and I had hardly reached the point where I felt like I belonged. He wandered in to say hi to the group after what I assumed was the end of day for Five Diamond. Part of me was taken aback. After all, this was Mike Sexton. He was the voice of the World Poker Tour, somebody that I'd been watching for the better part of a decade, somebody that I admired and respected, but most importantly, someone that I dreamt would eventually call my name as I made a major final table. Another part of me respected the fact that he was a player. And I recognized that even though we were at wildly different points of our career, we were on some level peers. As JRB greeted Mike, he worked his way around the table, introducing the commentary legend to the businessmen. I made myself small, as I often do when people who I deem to be larger than the game wander through those glass doors. But eventually I was spotted. JRB circled around to my end of the table, when to my shock, Mike exclaimed, "You let Berkey in here? You boys are in for a fight." I laughed it off and I wished him well in the Five Diamond, but deep down I was completely floored. I was a nobody. There was no explanation as to why he knew who I was. But that unsolicited acknowledgement told me all I'd ever need to know about Mike Sexton the man. He was larger than life, yet humble to the core. He was our ambassador. He welcomed with open arms anybody with the dream to compete, and he took the time to know your name. He was the voice of our game, and in a lot of ways, the friendly face we all needed. This game can be merciless, and so often we desperately need a pat on the back as a friendly reminder that there's far more to life than the turn of a card. Mike embodied that reminder. I truly want to believe that he spent his final days looking ahead with the same calming optimism that was reflected in his day-to-day life. Our community lost more than an ambassador. We lost a loved one. Rest easy, Mike.